It's one of the most hotly anticipated films to come out this year. In just 2 days' time, we will be able to see Mortal Kombat in cinemas. And we're joined today by two of the stars, Josh Lawson and Sisi Stringer. It is so good to have you both here.
Hello.
How exciting. OK, everyone knows what Mortal Kombat is. It was made into a movie a bunch of years ago, but this is just something out of this world. Tell people, first of all, what it's about. I mean, it's a game, but it's much more.
Where to begin? Do you want to field this one, Sis?
All right. It began as an arcade game. I think it was released 92 or 93, before I was born, sorry.
Can you believe that?
Yeah.
And basically it has all of these iconic characters. Oh, yeah, we can see it now. All of these iconic characters, and they fight, and it's quite brutal, and it's just a little bit violent, just a little bit R-rated. As the game developed and got released more, the graphics got better and better, and now the gore is pretty real. And hopefully that's what comes across in the movie.
Yeah. So ultimately Mortal Kombat is this tournament, right? Yeah. Essentially good versus evil, Earth realm, which are the humans, more or less, and there's Outer Realm, which is where the monsters, essentially, for want of a better word. Sorry, I haven't read it. No, I know what I'm talking about. And it's about that big battle for Earth, essentially, the heroes versus villains. And so that, at the heart, is what Mortal Kombat's about.
And the amazing thing is that it is just such an Aussie production. So Aussies have taken the lead. You've got an Aussie director, Simon. You've got Aussie actors. Mm-hmm. It was filmed partially in South Australia.
Yeah, almost entirely.
So to have this massive franchise, this massive studio picture with so much Australian influence, that must be exciting.
Yeah, and that was that was pre-COVID. Yeah. So, obviously what we're seeing now coming out, I know, it seems like ancient history now. Can you remember a life before COVID?
Yeah, I know.
But now that we're coming sort of out the back of this pandemic, Australia is obviously the place to be. Mm. Hollywood is coming back here en masse. Mm. The studios are getting snapped up by all these American productions. And I think Mortal Kombat really, sort of was the first domino to fall in what has been the purplest patch. Mm. For the Australian film industry now. So it's exciting to see where that's going to go.
And what a landscape as well. The diversity of landscapes in South Australia is incredible. Mm. We've got the deserts, we've got the forests, we've got the coal mines, we've got, everything. So they were able to do so much.
Simon, your director, was super keen not to rely too much on digital effects, to make it as real as possible, to make these worlds as real as possible.
Yeah.
So it sounds like you went to all those spots to make that happen, yeah?
Yeah, no, I think most of the CG budget went into giving me a six-pack. and then, everything else was pretty much in camera.
So modest. He worked really hard for it.
I can't believe I got away with that.
You do look incredible.
Hush now.
I have to say.
Bless your cotton socks.
Look at this.
Yeah, look, the makeup does all
Ooh.
Work. It's incredible how much acting a beard does for you.
Is that part of it?
Absolutely. There was a 2-week beard workshop at NIDA when I was there, and look at me now.
You're not going anywhere without
it. A little bit of grey in them.
Oh, just a little bit. Can you believe it?
Hey, Josh, it's actually nice to have you home.
Thank you.
Because usually when I see you, it's in the States.
Yeah.
Is it COVID or is this kind of the place to be now?
Look, I was thinking about coming back anyway, and then COVID made the decision really easy. So I'm really, really happy to be back. It's obviously the place to be, but I feel more at home now than I have in a long time. And I was there in the States for almost 15 years.
I know. Yeah.
So it really was my home away from home, but this feels like I've come back at the right time and it's where I need to be. And I brought my dog back with me, so we're both very happy. Yeah.
Well, the reason you were there was because you were working on some massive US productions, House of Lies and all the rest of it. So what was that experience like for you?
Yeah, well, it was so when I first got there, it would have been around 2008, and it was a different time. Aussies weren't going en masse the way they were maybe 5 years later. So there were some OG Aussies over there at that point, and then there was really the onslaught of Aussie talent. But had some ups and downs. There were many years where the work wasn't coming, and that's the industry. And so you take the good with the bad. But this one, I will say, Mortal Kombat came on the tail end of a bit of a drought for me.
The right time.
Yeah, I was very hungry for work.
Impeccable timing.
Yeah. CC, your character is very badass. badass, if I can say.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Is that your nature? Is that hidden Sisi coming out?
Oh, definitely.
Oh, my God.
Definitely. There is a knife-wielding assassin under this, you know, shirt. She's just such a ferocious character, and it's really exciting to be one of the few women in the cast, and the fact that I get to fight another bad boss woman and we have our clash together. And that's probably the scene I'm the most proud of, is our fight together. It looks wonderful and everyone did an amazing job, particularly our stunt women and Jess. So, yeah, I'm most excited to
Jess
see
is,
that.
Jess is, of course, Jess McNamee. It's an incredible cast. You're all incredible in it. Mortal Kombat is in cinemas, people. Go to the movies. It is on the big screen nationally, 22nd of April. That's Thursday. Thank you, Josh and Sisi.
Thank you.
So great to see you both.
You too.